รายการต่อไปนี้เป็นรายการทั่วไปสามารถรับชมได้ทุกวัย
สนับสนุนโดยธนาคารกสิกรไทยบริการทุกระดับประทับใจ
เขาพูดถึงคำว่าเต๋อเขาพูดถึงคำว่าคุณธรรม
เ
พราะฉะนั้นเป็นอะไรที่คิดว่ามันสอดคล้องกับสิ่งที่อยู่ในใจเขา mindset ของเขาแล้วก็เขาต้องการให้วัฒนธรรมองค์กรของเขาเนี่ยมีเรื่องคุณธรรมนำในส่วนนี้ซึ่งผมเชื่อนะฮะว่าเขาไม่ใช่เรื่องบังเอิญที่ทำไมเขาถึงเลือกคนที่อยู่ในวัฒนธรรมที่ใกล้เคียงแล้วก็บวกการศึกษาชั้นดีของตะวันตกมาในส่วน
ห่วงเวลานี้น้อยคนนักที่ไม่รู้จักแจ็คมาผู้ก่อตั้งอาลีบาบากรุ๊ปกลุ่มธุรกิจอีคอมเมิร์ซอันทรงพลังมหาเศรษฐีอันดับต้นๆของจีนด้วยทรัพย์สินมูลค่า 1.95 หมื่นล้านดอลลาร์จากการประเมินของ Forbesแจ็คมาเคยมาเยือนไทย2ครั้งพร้อมหมายมั่นปั้นมือว่ามีโอกาสเดินทางมาเยือนไทยครั้งต่อไปจะยกทีมเจรจาชุดใหญ่มาด้วยคุณสุทธิชัยยุนผู้ก่อตั้งเครือเนชั่นยกทีมงานบุกถึงเมืองหางโจวสาธารณรัฐประชาชนจีนฐานที่มั่นใหญ่อาลีบาบากรุ๊ปถือโอกาสสัมภาษณ์พิเศษแจ็คมาประธานใหญ่เกี่ยวกับจุดอ่อนและจุดแข็งของประเทศไทยในด้านการค้าอิเล็กทรอนิกส์และโอกาสของอาลีบาบากรุ๊ปในการเข้ามาเป็นหุ้นส่วนทางเศรษฐกิจในภูมิภาคอาเซียนแจ็คมาผู้ก่อตั้งและประธานคณะกรรมการบริหารอาลีบาบากรุ๊ปยักษ์ใหญ่ด้านอีคอมเมิร์ซของจีนให้สัมภาษณ์คุณสุทธิชัยยุนผู้ก่อตั้งเครือเนชั่นเกี่ยวกับจุดอ่อนและจุดแข็งของไทยในด้านการค้าอิเล็กทรอนิกส
์ Thank you Jack for accepting my request for this interview
Thank you very much for coming all the way here
You have launched or soft launched a cashierless coffee shop.
I think, you know, when you have resources of great young people, mm-hmm. when you have all the technology you have, when you have a lot of money, mm-hmm. I mean, the money is the social resources you have, mm-hmm. you think is that how you can enable the society?
Yeah.
How can you spend the resources and use the resources in the most efficient way mm-hmm. so people, human beings can benefit? Mm-hmm. Because we are already one of the biggest internet companies in the world
yes.
and in China. Mm-hmm. It's not about thinking about only making money. Mm-hmm. It's thinking about how using technology, using the young talents you have to enable others. Mm-hmm. So for example, the cashless coffee shop, that we try to make China a cashless society in 5 years. We are back counting now.
The whole country.
The whole country.
The whole of China will become cashless society
in 5 years. And this city today, mm-hmm. this city, our city, use a mobile phone. You don't need to have any cash. Mm-hmm. You go text, you do anything mm-hmm. without have cash. Mm-hmm. So we are moving in 5 years, we'll make the China a cashless society. And if China can make it happen, why other country cannot make it happen? Mm-hmm. So this is something that dream. The cashless society, a cashless coffee shop is just a concept image. You know, it's just like something we will do. The society will look like that in the future.
This will represent the whole society one day.
Yeah, one day. Mm-hmm. And our goal is in 5 years. So we're moving very aggressively. Mm-hmm. So we hope that there are millions of Chinese people go to Thailand.
Sure.
What we want these guys go to Thailand is just a mobile phone and mm-hmm. passport.
Yes.
They can do anything. They don't need to have to bring cash. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And they can go any shop and mm-hmm. bars and hotels. They use a mobile phone payment to do. In the future, they don't even need a passport.
Yeah.
So everything can be done.
Mm-hmm. So talking about Thailand,
yeah.
Do you plan to visit Thailand again soon?
Yeah.
What are you going to do in Thailand?
I'm expecting to having visiting the Thailand this year.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, my last trip in Thailand was very fruitful.
Yeah.
And thanks to Prime Minister and the Cabinet, mm-hmm. all the ministers treat us very well.
You have his picture here with you here.
Yes. Yeah.
Picture of the yeah. Prime Minister Prayut with you.
Yes. And I remember the wonderful days I had in Thailand mm-hmm. and talking to the young people there uh-huh. and business people there. But since I came back, you know, the king passed away.
Yeah.
And I feel sorry. I know that Thailand's whole country is mm-hmm. in a big sorrow. Mm-hmm. So we said, let's wait for a while. And I think both we're getting deals progressing,
mm-hmm.
but not in a big size. So I'm thinking about going there, this time taking our CEO and our team, Alipay, uh-huh. logistic, e-commerce, together go to Thailand.
So the whole package from
Alibaba. It's a whole package. Mm-hmm. We want, based on the achievement and the agreement we had
mm-hmm.
Last time, mm-hmm. so we were upgrading our partnership.
เขามาแน่
ใช่
เพราะว่าเท่าที่ทราบเนี่ยในการรันในเมืองไทยของเขาเนี่ยเขาใช้ Lazada
ครับ
Lazada เขาซื้อไปเมื่อปี1ปลายปี14หรือ15เนี่ยนะครับ
ครับ
แล้วก็เท่าที่ทราบนะฮะว่าแผนของ Lazada ก็คือจะเริ่มเป็นรูปเป็นร่างคือปัจจุบันดำเนินการอยู่ที่เขตเศรษฐกิจพิเศษตะวันออก
ครับ
นะ EAC
ครับ
แล้วก็จะเริ่มดำเนินการได้ประมาณต้นปี62
อืม
นะ
You already have Lazada
yeah
mm-hmm. and Lazada is quite active in Thailand and
good.
Southeast Asia
good
you already have taken up 83% of Lazada Alibaba
yeah 80 yes. 80 something percent of the Lazada and Lazada is like a e-commerce company Southeast Asia what we think about is how can we help Thailand
mm-hmm.
to be more connected to China market
ah.
to be connected to the Southeast Asia market and mm-hmm. to the other country so as I said the five global think global buy, global sell, and global deliver, global financing, and global travel.
Uh-huh.
This is the five global functions that mm-hmm. we want to enable Thailand, small business, young people mm-hmm. that be able to do it. So we want to connect Thailand with the other countries, mm-hmm. especially China.
Mm-hmm. Also the EEC in Thailand, the Eastern Corridor
yeah.
Economic Zone,
yeah.
which I think Lazada is interested, or Alibaba is interested in setting up a park, an e-park or an e-commerce park there. Is that right?
Yeah, I heard the team is working on that. Mm-hmm. And because I'm thinking about the CEO, Daniel, and I'm thinking about how we can enable Thailand to be more globalized.
Uh-huh.
Yes, to be more connected to the China market because so many Chinese people travel in Thailand. They love the Thailand mm-hmm. fruits. They love to partner with there. So something that we want to be upgrading it's not like we did in the past years, how we can be make Thailand more connected mm-hmm. to the other part of the world.
Mm-hmm. So EEC of Thailand is part of the activities you are planning?
I think so, mm-hmm. yeah.
Because
I have not talking to the Lazada team about that project yet,
mm-hmm.
because now the thing that we are doing there, I think the more we do it, the more we understand Thailand.
Yes.
And the more we want Thailand people in the business can understand Alibaba, mm-hmm. so they can leverage mm-hmm. e-commerce, leverage Alibaba facilities. Mm-hmm. But definitely, Thailand is such an important country, as I said last time in Thailand. Yes.
Right.
Such an important country in the areas.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely we pay a special attention to that.
สนับสนุนโดยธนาคารกสิกรไทยบริการทุกระดับประทับใจ
ตอนเพราะตอนนั้นที่แจ็คเราเชิญมาร่วมเอเชียไดอะล็อก
ครับ
นั่นนะฮะก็เคยบอกว่าจะมาลงทุนเมืองไทยเสร็จแล้วมันก็เงียบหายไปพักหนึ่ง
ครับ
ก็เคยมีคนลงในโซเชียลเยอะบอกว่าโอ้เนี่ยเห็นไหมอย่างโน้นอย่างนี้เนี่ยเมืองไทยเขาไม่สนใจแล้วอะไรทำนองนี้ที่จริงเปล่าเพราะโครงการนี้เป็นโครงการใหญ่นะฮะแล้วเสร็จแล้วก็มีคนบอกว่าเนี่ยเขาหนีไปมาเลเซียแล้วเขาไม่เอาประเทศไทยแล้วที่จริงไม่ใช
่
นะผมเคยไปเรียนถามผู้รู้นะคุณกอบศักดิ์ภูตระกูล
ครับ
ท่านบอกว่าเปล่ามาเลเซียเนี่ยเขาต้องการสร้างดิจิตอลฮับนะเพราะฉะนั้นเนี่ยแจ็คไปทำเขาจะเชิญแจ็คเป็นที่ปรึกษาก็ไปทำก็ทำไป
ครับ
แต่ของไทยเนี่ยจะเป็นอีคอมเมิร์ซฮับนะเพราะว่าเราอยู่ในประเทศศูนย์กลางที่มันกระจายสินค้าไปสู่ CMLV ได้ง่ายนะแล้วก็ประเทศอื่นอีกในภูมิภาคนี
้
เพราะฉะนั้นโครงการนี้มันยังคงอยู
่ Thailand can also be a gateway to CLMV Cambodia Laos Myanmar Vietnam This is what Thailand's position or is trying to position itself as the gateway to CLMV Do you see the same way see it Thailand as a possible gateway to the rest of the region?
Well, we think that in that whole region, we are really reshaping it because not every country have the five elements.
Yes.
Right? Mm-hmm. You buy, sell, financing, deliver, and travel. And travel. And Thailand is among very few countries that have the five functions. So we pay very special attention to Thailand. We are still figuring out because I think our team, our strategic team, is still researching deeply about how we can function Thailand in a better way. But definitely, Thailand is such an important country, as I said last time in Thailand, such an important country in the areas. So definitely, we pay a special attention to that.
Apart from Thailand, your strategy in ASEAN, say Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, and the rest, Indonesia, what is the big picture?For you in ASEAN?
Yeah, there are five countries that we are paying special attention to. You know, we visited Thailand first, and the Malaysia Prime Minister, he came and he made a quick move and action to making sure that Malaysia is the e-hub for the EWTP of the area. And they built up the first sample EWTP hub there. And we also pay special attention to Pakistan.We are working on that very quickly. And we are also think that Vietnam is also very important, and Philippines. So these are the five countries. Of course, Cambodia is something that our team, young people, are very interested in visiting. So I think the five countries we think that we will start with. Now the EWTP, the first the sample thing is Malaysia. But since Thailand, I visited the first. So we think that in Thailand, because the Chinese people go to Thailand, so many, how we can make that part.Be more like connected to China at the part. This is something that we're still working on. So I think I tried to, before this interview, I talked to the team, can you give me something really interesting? They said, no. We will let you know when the whole plan is ready. But one thing for sure that this time I go to Thailand, I think a big delegation for Alibaba Group will go together.
We'll be
from logistic, of financing, e-commerce, and cloud computing, and all the key persons will go there.
Full range of Alibaba presence will be there.
They will go there together.
What does Thailand need to do more than what it has been doing in order to make you confident that your investment, your expansion into Thailand will be worthwhile? What exactly do you think we still lack? What drawbacks? You can be frank about it because I would like your message to go to the government, to go to the private sector, the bureaucrats in Thailand.
I think, there's something that we could do is that the talent probably should move much faster. Because we honestly, we were shocked by Malaysia's speed.
Oh, really?
The Prime Minister said, in 3 months, I will make this thing happen.
Wow.
So we thought, oh my God, 3 months is almost impossible. Right. He made it happen.
Not even Jack Ma could do it.
Yeah, I mean, it's a huge project.
Yes.
So they make it in 3 months, they made it happen, and they make the, they agreed, they built up a great strong team to follow up. They opened the, all the custom offices and inspection offices.
Wow.
They give the land, all things be done.
Mm-hmm.
So I think Thailand should be moving, speed should be faster.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
this is something that we expect.
Mm-hmm.
Because, but we understand that maybe because of the pathway of the king,
you're
that
right.
slowed down all mm-hmm. the things.
Mm-hmm.
And but this time we come there, we would love to have the same speed because mm-hmm. for business mm-hmm. like us, mm-hmm. we need a speed, we need execution,
sure.
we need a result.
Sure.
When we have a result, mm-hmm. then things, resources can be put inside.
Mm-hmm. And also action.
The action, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is what we think that, you know, last time the Malaysia, the speed surprised us.
Yes.
The efficiency, we said, wow, 3 months, it's down. And the team were all impressed. Yeah. So I think
Did they deliver the goods on time?
Yeah.
They did?
Really
wow.
in time.
Wow.
Oh, that yeah. impressed us.
Mm-hmm.
And that mm-hmm. is that is something that we hope, and I believe Thailand can do that thing too, because
yeah.
you have a great talents, you have a mm-hmm. very quick move government.
Mm-hmm.
So this time we're going there, everything we agreed, we just to get things done.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
ไทยควรจะได้ประโยชน์อะไรจากแจ็คหม่าการที่แจ็คหม่าพยายามจะมามีปฏิสัมพันธ์กับไทยก็จะมาเยือนไทยก่อนสิ้นปีด้วยเนี่ย
ผมคิดว่าประโยชน์ที่เราจะได้นะครับคืออย่าไปกลัวว่าเขาจะมาฮุบหากว่าใครจะฮุบไม่ใช่คุณกลัวแล้วจะเกิดประโยชน
์
คุณปรับตัวอย่างไรต่างหากนะ
Some of the local and regional e-commerce companies, you know, medium size, small size, asked me to deliver their concern to you
mm-hmm.
that when Alibaba comes as a big sweep,
mm-hmm.
then you're going to wipe them away.
Mm-hmm.
How can they survive with Alibaba? How can Alibaba help them? Because if you come in and you take over most of the activities, then they cannot survive.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think their concern is valid?
No, I think probably people know very little about Alibaba business model. We first are not interested in local market.
Mm-hmm.
We're interested in bringing the local products to the world, to China.
Uh-huh.
This is always our focus.
Mm-hmm.
And Amazon and eBay have been worrying about us for a long time, so we never go to America. We say, oh, we'll bring American small business to China.
Uh-huh.
This is what we do.
Uh-huh.
So principle number one, we are not that interested in the local market. Even mm-hmm. in India, such a huge market, we mm-hmm. just invest in local mm-hmm. partners,
mm-hmm.
let them do it. So we are not interested in, we are not focusing on go to Thailand and say, hey, we build mm-hmm. up a local e-commerce company, wipe out all the other stuff.
No.
Unless they need us, unless they say, please come here,
yes.
and we need that.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, we are only interested in bring Thailand to the world.
Mm-hmm.
That's number one. Number two, our model, as always, we go to the local country
mm-hmm.
to enable the partners. We never do ourselves.
Uh-huh.
We're finding partners. Lazada is the company we acquired.
Mm-hmm.
Lazada is not the company we built up ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
But Lazada has a great influence in the Southeast Asia.
Mm-hmm.
So we are also improving Lazada model.
Yes.
And we want to making sure Lazada in the future will also enable the local partners
mm-hmm.
instead of doing a lot of things ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So go to Thailand for the small, medium-sized e-commerce companies. Don't worry.
Mm-hmm.
If they want to compete with us to helping Thailand products to China, to the other world, maybe it's tough.
Yeah.
But if they do serve the customers locally wise, it would be great.
Mm-hmm.
And we will be happy to enable them
mm-hmm.
using our technology, mm-hmm. even using our money if they need, mm-hmm. or the know-how to enable them to do mm-hmm. better local services.
Mm-hmm.
So our model is different from the USA. USA going any country, they want to control themselves.
Right. Mm-hmm.
We go anywhere. The first thing we do is looking for partner.
Uh-huh.
And then if it's a good partner,
them.
Enable them.
Build them up.
Yes, that's mm-hmm. all we will do about
mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
if there are any great the local mm-hmm. Company, they need us,
mm-hmm.
we'll be very happy to discuss.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So
you are going to be able to raise their living standards, and you're going to change the world, because
this is,
then they can compete.
Yeah.
If you really accomplish that mission.
This is all my life is passionate about. Mm-hmm. As I said, the world need not only B20, we need B200, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. We should have a B200 countries together. Yes. We should enable small countries, mm-hmm. small business, mm-hmm. young people. Mm-hmm. This is the value that mm-hmm. Alibaba Resources can do, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So just like a teaching the rural area teachers, principals,
yes.
it's easy to giving money to the principals and headmaster in the big cities. Mm-hmm. But go to the country. I think this is the unique, the rural area principles of headmasters. Mm-hmm. If we can enable them, we are mm-hmm. creating unique value. Mm-hmm. So if we can help Thailand, if we yes. can help Malaysia, yes. if we can help the Philippines, if we can help Laos, these countries to be sold to the big countries.
Yeah, that would be a great
this
mission.
This is the great value we can bring mm-hmm. to. So this mm-hmm. is what...
Yeah. I think if
and big companies do not need us, developed countries do not need us.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because in the past you had mistakes and you had failures, so this could happen again to Alibaba.
Yeah, that's why we need to invite more young people, more mm-hmm. great people, mm-hmm. and I should not. Many of the companies built by good people
yeah.
and destroyed by the same group of people. Because when they get old, they get stupid. When they get crazy, yeah. they got arrogant. They got you know.
You said once that when you have more money, you become stupid.
Yeah, that's true. And
when
crazy.
You become rich, you become stupider.
Yeah, I worry. I think I'm a human being.
Yes.
I will be crazy. I will be stupid.
Yes.
I will get old. I will get
yes.
slow.
Yes.
And I found that I'm much slower than years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So it's time.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be ready. Okay. Leave the job
mm-hmm.
for the other people.
Mm-hmm.
Trust the other people are smarter than you are.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This is always I believe. I believe the other people are smarter than I am.
Mm-hmm. There could always be another Jack Ma to destroy
the
old Jack Ma.
There will be millions of Jack Ma in human history. We are just happen to be lucky.
Mm-hmm.
I see this very clearly. And
mm-hmm.
I know myself that, you know, as I said,
mm-hmm.
The day when I started the business, I said to my 18 founders, I said, if Jack Ma and his team, if we can be successful, mm-hmm. 80% of the young people can be successful.
Because uh-huh.
mm-hmm. we don't have resources.
Mm-hmm.
We're
mm-hmm.
not that smart.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have that many PhDs,
mm-hmm.
MBAs.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have money.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The only thing we do is that we believe the future.
Mm-hmm.
We work together,
mm-hmm.
tiny by tiny. We learn from the market, learn from the people.
Mm-hmm.
And then one day, when we get old, we stop learning.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
And then we will die. So mm-hmm. why not leave an opportunity for those people continue to learn?
Mm-hmm. How would disruptive technology like AI, artificial mm-hmm. intelligence, and robotics affect you or enable you?
We've been doing that for 8 years ago. We started to transform our company from e-commerce to data company.
Mm-hmm.
We pay very special attention
mm-hmm.
to robots.
Mm-hmm.
to the artificial intelligence, machine intelligence.
Mm-hmm.
But the only thing is not only enable us, we always want to enable small business,
mm-hmm.
developing countries. Our philosophy is always like this.
Mm-hmm.
The world should be inclusive. The technology we have, we should be inclusive to every small business, every young people,
mm-hmm.
every developing country, mm-hmm. so making sure everybody can do it.
Mm-hmm.
So because we're the service provider of this technology, we can charge a little bit, we can be good.
Yes.
The artificial intelligence or machine learning or cloud computing is going to disrupt us.
No.
Because we think we were using this technology
mm-hmm.
to enable human beings,
uh-huh.
enable small business.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we're learning that very quickly.
Mm. And that will also empower your business too, if the small businesses make use of
yeah.
the...
Empower others is empower yourself.
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
what we think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
In the future, it's not that we say it's not e-commerce, it's not e-trade, it's e-business. We say it's not made in China, it's not made in Thailand, it's made
mm-hmm.
in internet.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is connected.
Mm-hmm.
You may design in America, manufacture in the Thailand,
mm-hmm.
and assemble it in China and sell all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
This will be the future of the world.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody can stop it.
สนับสนุนโดย Eurocake อร่อยทุกที่ทุกเวลา Premium Outlet Factory Outlet ของแบรนด์เนมระดับพรีเมียมโดเน่ป๊อปบีนเขียวมันหอมอร่อย
มันเป็นเรื่องเดียวกันกับ Google กับ Facebook ที่มาแย่งรายได้จากวงการสื
่
อวงการโฆษณาของไทยเหมือนกัน
แล้
วก็ไม่ใช่เท่าอย่างเดียวอย่างว่าอาเซียนเพื่อนเราก็จะเจอปัญหานี้เหมือนกันแล้วแต่คณิตมองยังไง
ผมคิดว่ามีถ้าสรุปตอนนี้มันมี4ปาร์ตี้4กลุ่มที่เกี่ยวข้องกลุ่มที่ได้ประโยชน์แน่คือกลุ่มของเราที่ส่งออกใช่มั้ยครับถือโอกาสเนี้ยแขวนบนอีคอมเมิร์ซของเขาไปเข้าเมืองจีนใช่มั้ยครับกลุ่มผู้ส่งออกกับกลุ่มผู้ผลิตที่เป็นผู้ส่งออกรายย่อยทั้งหลายแหละเนี่ยเป็นกลุ่มที่ควรจะได้ประโยชน์ควรจะได้ประโยชน์กลุ่มอีก2กลุ่มที่มีอยู่คือกลุ่มที่ทำธุรกิจอีคอมเมิร์ซในไทยใช่ไหมครับกับกลุ่มสุดท้ายคือกลุ่มผู้ผลิตในประเทศไทยสำหรับกรณีกลุ่มผู้ผลิตในประเทศไทยเนี่ยตอบง่ายนิดหนึ่งคือการค้าระหว่างประเทศมันมีเทรดออฟแพ้ชนะอยู่แล้วแต่ว่ากรณีที่เข้ามาทำเนี่ยนะถึงแม้ว่าจะทำในประเทศไทยเมื่อเข้าตลาดเมืองไทยต้องคอมพลายทูไทยรูจะต้องมีภาษีจะต้องมีอะไรอย่างนั้นตามปกตินะครับไอ้ TS การแข่งขันเนี่ยมันก็คล้ายๆเดิมยกเว้นว่าจะมีการทุ่มตลาดซึ่งก็มีกฎหมายเรื่องการทุ่มตลาดอยู่แล้วต้องไปว่ากันถูกไหมครับการค้าปกติไม่มีอีคอมเมิร์ซมันก็มีเรื่องนี้อยู
่
แต่เหลือสุดท้ายที่ยังเป็นห่วงก็คือว่ากลุ่มที่เป็นผู้ประกอบการอีคอมเมิร์ซของไทยเองเนี่ยจะเข้าไปร่วมมือกับเขาได้ยังไงหรือว่าจะได้ประโยชน์จากเรื่องพวกนี
้ The trend in the world now is anti-globalization What is your thinking about that
because it's impossible
Yeah, because the trend in the United States and in some European countries, what do you think will happen to this anti-globalization?
It's a fever or it's a flu. We'll get over it.
You get over it?
It will get over it because nobody can stop globalization.
Mm-hmm.
Human beings become more mobile.
Mm-hmm.
When people travel,
you
can never stop trade.
Mm-hmm.
When people travel, you can never stop business.
Right.
In the future, it's not that we say it's not e-commerce, it's not e-trade, it's e-business.
E-business.
We say it's not made in China, it's not made in Thailand, it's made in internet.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is connected.
Mm-hmm.
You may design in America, manufacture in the Thailand, and assemble it in China and sell all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
This will be the future of the world.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody can stop it.
Not even Donald Trump?
No.Nobody can. This is the nature. This is the trend. Nobody can stop it. But I think what Donald Trump, I don't think he wants to stop global trade. He wants to improve it. I discussed with him about helping small business selling things across the board, enable small business to do global trade. He agreed that. That's why I had a Detroit meeting, very successful. So I think the globalization should be improved, should be more inclusive. It should not be determined. You know, globalization did a wonderful job in the past 30 years, I mean, but nothing is perfect. It's only 30 years.Compared to human history, it's like a baby. You should not kill the baby because he cries.
Yeah.
Right? Improve it. So my job, I think, and our job is to improve the globalization, improve the pure trade to business alliance, to partnership, to enable every young people and a small business can do the business cross-board instead of...just the big companies, big countries.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very optimistic. This is a flu. It's just a flu. It's just a catch a cold and then people got upset and then you take some medicine, you relax and then think about it clearly, you'll come back. So I bet in 5 years you will see it.
Jack Ma ชอบใช้เวลาว่างไปกับการอ่านและเขียนนิยายกังฟูเล่นไพ่โบเกอร์นั่งสมาธิและฝึกไทชีศิลปะการฝึกร่างกายและจิตใจตามอย่างชาวจีนโบราณเขาว่าการฝึกไทชี่นี่แหละช่วยให้ร่างกายและจิตใจรับมือกับการทำงานและชีวิตส่วนตัวได้เป็นอย่างดี
Are you a Buddhist?
I'm a Buddhist. I'm Taoism And I also the respect Confucius, and I respect the Christian and Islam. I read a lot of things. Yes. I said, wow, this is the human wisdoms. Uh-huh. And I feel a lot of comfortable when I read the Buddhism.
I see. And do you do meditation from time to time?
I do.
And when you read books, martial arts novels, and you practice your Tai Chi Quan,
yeah.
Do they help you in your work,
of course,
daily work?
Tai Chi is about the yin and yang, about the balance.
Yin yang?
Yin and yang balance. It's not about attack, it's about protect.
Uh-huh.
So it's all about the balance.
Uh-huh.
Everything the company we're doing is all about the balance.
Uh-huh.
About, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And be harmonious to yourself, heart, and body, and soul, and environment. The theme of Chinese Taoism is how to change yourself to mm-hmm. be harmonious to the environment,
yes.
to the nature.
Right.
The theme of the Buddhism is how to change your behavior to be harmonious to the society and
yes.
the community,
yes.
right?
Mm-hmm.
The theme of Confucius mm-hmm. is how to change yourself to be harmonious to the society.
Right. You believe in life after death, the next life?
I hope there is a life after death.
You hope so?
Yeah, I hope so.
What would you like to be born to be in your next life?
Yeah, Anamopia said yes a few days ago, be a woman and have two kids and have a small tiny business, something I love to do and not too much responsibility.
You have been compared to, someone has said that you are, Jack Ma is like Bill Gates, part of Bill Gates, part of Jeff Bezos, part of Steve Jobs, part of Larry Page's, part of Sergey Brin and Mark Zuckerberg rolled into one. So you are really a big mess because they're trying to put all these...
I'm learning from each person.
Really?
You know, I learn a lot from these guys talking. It's a lot of people in the business world, people
yes.
love to have competitors.
Yes.
So I said again, many years, I don't have a competitors.
No.
Because why are you looking for... there are competitors everywhere. So you
right.
see, when you see these people, you have to see what you can learn from this guy.
Right.
What you can learn from this business. What
yes.
you can learn from the the vision and the mission of that guy and put inside to learn. So I think when you talk, when you see these great people, you may not like him, but you ask what you can learn from him.
Right.
And when you learn from him, you start to respect,
yes.
appreciate,
yes.
and then you start to like him.
Mm-hmm. So you don't necessarily like all of them?
Well, I like, fortunately, I like all these guys.
Right, because they are different, because they are innovators, right?
They are very unique.
And they inspire you when you started?
Oh, do. I mean, do.
Bill Gates especially? Because I was reading books about you, and uh-huh. first... few years when you started, Bill Gates was your idol, was
yeah,
your
like Bill Gates was the role model for many, many young people when we were young.
Right.
But later I found, oh my God, he's that big, so how can I catch up? Right? But, you know, I started my business almost the same year as a Jeff Bezos.
Yes.
Then American environment make him so... make the business grow so fast.
Mm-hmm.
And I know Mark Zuckerberg for years,
yes.
I know Larry Page for years.
Yes.
And
mm-hmm.
So I think as a business people, do not think about competition more.
Mm-hmm.
You should think about learning from your competitors,
mm-hmm.
learning from those great leaders. There mm-hmm. must be something unique you have to learn.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, you said Alibaba will last 102 years?
Yes.
And that your ultimate goal will be to serve 2 billion consumers around
yes.
the world
yep.
and to help 10 million companies to
be profitable.
Be profitable.
And create 100 million jobs for
right.
the world.
Yeah. You are now 52. I worked on this. You want the company to be 102 years old.
Yeah, we have 84 years to go.
84 years to go. By then you will be 146 years old.
Yeah.
Will you live to that date and see Alibaba accomplished the mission that you set now?
I wish I could, but this is I think it's a four rally. It's everybody just only run for 100 meters. I give my this thing to next torch to the next person.
Uh-huh.
This is what we designed our motto.
Mm-hmm.
So I am the first CEO
mm-hmm.
and first the chairman of the company. I will not be the second or third. We have right now great CEOs. and then in the future we're going to have a good chairman. So I will retire. As I said,
you will.
It's I retire not because I want to have an easy life. I retire, I think this company, leave this opportunity for young people.
Mm-hmm.
They can do better job.
Mm-hmm.
You have to continue to run. Because
mm-hmm.
when you are 55 or 60 or 65, your brain cannot run that fast. Your
yeah.
energy is not good.
Right.
So you should leave the position,
mm-hmm.
leave the opportunity, leave the challenge to the next successor.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been preparing for this for many years.
Uh-huh.
And in this way to continue. So I think I also want to set example to mm-hmm. many entrepreneurs in the world that give opportunity, challenges, chance for young people.
So when are you going to retire? Officially?
Officially?
Practically?
I stepped down from CEO positions
yes.
In the year 2012. So I've been the chairman for 5 years.
Yes.
And I think sooner or later, I'm preparing. I cannot announce it now, but I know everything is on track. You have
on
to have
track,
a,
huh?
Yeah, on track. We have a great team successors, team ready.
Yes,
we have
yes.
a training leaderships.
Right.
I have a lot of things to do when I retire. I have
what would you want to do?
Jack Ma Foundation.
Yes.
You know, the philanthropy things I want to do. And the Hupan University, Entrepreneur University, to be
yes.
the teacher.
Mm-hmm.
And these are the main stuff I want to do. I have a lot of things.
I prepared a lot of things. So you want to go back to become teacher again?
I go back to teach.
Mm-hmm.
This is something, you know, people, we build up the company.
Mm-hmm.
We have the kid, but you do not own the kids.
No.
The kids have to be owned by society,
yes.
mm-hmm. by himself.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So the company, we build it up. And the company should have its own life.
Yes.
Right. When mm-hmm. the child is 18 years old, let him go.
Mm-hmm.
You are the father. Don't follow him all everywhere. Right? Don't be there.
Yeah.
So I think let him enjoy himself. I can enjoy myself.
Right.
So I hope the day when I die and then people say, well, he's a great teacher. And he happened to make a one joint to find
what
a one company.
What would you like to be remembered as when after that? After to die. What would you like the world people to talk about Jack Ma? Oh, he's a great Alibaba guy. Oh, he started e-commerce. What would be the proudest remarks you want people to say about you?
Yeah, probably he is a teacher.
He's a good, damn good teacher.
Yeah, he's a good teacher and very unique person.
Yes.
And happened to make a company called Alibaba. I mean, that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Alibaba is one of my. It's something that it's been done by millions of people. It's
mm-hmm.
not me. I happen to have an idea and
mm-hmm.
have a great people that and team
mm-hmm.
that working together. That's
mm-hmm.
it. It's not like my masterpiece.
Mm-hmm.
It's our masterpiece. It's the society's masterpiece.
Yeah.
Jack พูดเสมอว่าความล้มเหลวเป็นส่วนหนึ่งของความสำเร็จของตัวเขาและ Alibaba.ปรัชญาสำคัญคือต้องปรับตัวและตื่นตัวกับสถานการณ์จริงและสนามแข่งขันจริงเสมอไม่ยึดตำราหรือลอกเรียนโมเดลทางธุรกิจของใครการเรียนรู้จากความล้มเหลวนี่แหละที่ทำให้เขาเป็นมหาเศรษฐีอันดับต้นๆของจีนได้